couple breakup, Chrishell Stouse and Kiyo Motsepe have broken up. They met on Dancing with the Stars. We talked about the beginning of their relationship. Very cute couple, thought it would work. You know, we weren't really sure what was going on with Chrishell and Gleb, and this little love connection was made between Chrishell and Kiyo. It's only been a couple months, but Chrishell has made us seem that this was a little messier than they tried to make it seem. And this is funny to me because it's also like the level of celebrity, right? You know, sometimes when it's a massive, massive star and you can see a source close to blank speaks out, you're like, okay, that could actually be like a different person. When you see source close to Kiyo, it's like, well, this could be coming from Kiyo himself, you know? Mm-hmm. So this People article, Chrishell screenshotted it. And the last line had said, Kiyo was heartbroken. He enjoyed his time with Chrishell and was 100% in it. A source close to Motsepe tells People, he's had a tough time with his mom's passing, but he really wanted to make his relationship with Chrishell last, adds the source. And Chrishell wrote, okay, I truly wanted to keep this drama free, but playing the victim and bringing your mom into it is a step too far for me. Taking the high road is overrated sometimes. I was also 100% in it as well until revelations Until revelations told to me recently have made me question if you could even order a coffee without lying. Woo! So Chrishell's calling him a big fat liar. And you know what? Sometimes taking the high road is overrated. I feel like it probably felt good for her to post these stories to get this out there, especially because if you really try and make it amicable, and Chrishell had posted like what the article had said as like the source close to Chrishell was that it was just an amicable split and it is what it is and they enjoyed their time together and now they're moving on. But Keo's source had brought up, you know, his mom passing away and how he really wanted to make it work, which makes it seem like the reason why they didn't work was Chrishell. So obviously she had to say something. She calls him a liar, and then she posted another story where someone had replied and said, I know you're upset, but this isn't from his own mouth. Who knows who this person is and if this is an accurate representation of his feelings? And Chrishell wrote, I gathered all the facts before I posted. Don't worry. I know exactly where it came from, which just makes me think that that was actually a source close to Motsepe is actually Kiyo.
Right. Listen, I live for this kind of petty drama, and I am team Chrishell because I feel like she's been done dirty multiple times. I feel like, you know, maybe she's been wrong and we don't know about it. There's two sides to every story, but I feel like she's been done dirty a few times. And I feel like if you need to mention that somebody can't even order a coffee without lying, then they got to be a liar. And can we maybe start the movement that taking the high road is overrated? Let's start that movement up. Taking the high road sometimes is overrated. I fully agree with that. I think that there are certain situations that some people might say, oh, take the high road. Yeah. Oh, don't pay them any mind. Take the high. Why? Why are we taking the high road? Why does Chrishell have to take the high road in this? If she's pissed off and she wants to be petty about it, let her be petty. He must have done something dirty. Yeah. He must have been a liar, maybe a cheat, maybe something else. We don't know. But if you mention, I think if you mention the words, can't even order a coffee without lying, you are a full-blown pathological liar.
Yeah, definitely. And if, especially if they, when they broke up, they had a conversation to say, like, let's try and keep this as drama-free as possible and not say anything, and then he puts that out in the press, yeah, you're going to be fucking pissed. Like, another response was, I think you're too mature for all of this. It's best to ignore it. This kind of comes off childish. And Chrishell wrote, yes, I am aware. If I end up alone with cats, it was worth it. But I am also human and not a robot. When you are the ass in the breakup and then the other person tries to let you save face and take the high road publicly, probably best not to poke a bear holding receipts. I will try to be a better person tomorrow. Today wasn't the day.
I love it. I love it. Don't you love that a little bit, though?
I respect that to be like, look, you know what? I try and take the high road. Today is just not the day. I'll be better tomorrow. But for right now, in this moment, I'm pissed off and I'm not going to let this guy fucking get away with making me look like I was the bad guy in our relationship.
Absolutely. And I think it's, you know, people always on the internet, it goes back to what we say, you know, this person on, because these people's lives are so public, and what we talk about on this podcast is a lot of celebrity, you know, whoever, influencer, whatever, pop culture, we cover it all. Their lives are public. So people have, and we have opinions. That's what we do on this show. But it pisses me off when people's opinions sometimes are like, oh, be the mature one, be the mature one, when they've been done wrong.
Yeah.
Like if the other person, you know, didn't necessarily do anything wrong, and then all of a sudden you start speaking about it and you're blowing up everything, you're given information that, you know, another, whatever, you know what I mean. Like there's certain circumstances where it's like two people mutually agree that we're not going to speak about something, and then somebody goes out of the way, like this situation. There comes a time where it's like, we got to throw maturity out of the window. So always people are like, be mature. Why can't we be a little immature sometimes? Why? Why can't we be a little immature sometimes? Look, you could be both mature and immature.
Everyone has their moments. Yeah, everybody has their moments. And it is, especially when it comes to relationship things and you feel like your name is now being dragged through the mud when you didn't do anything, you're going to want to say something.
Yeah, and the people who comment, oh, be mature, take the higher road. Are you doing that every day in your life? Tell me. Are you doing that every day in your life? Because I doubt you are.
Doubt it.
I doubt you are. So, you know, good for Chrishell.
Yeah. That marks the end of Chrishell and Keo's relationship. It doesn't seem like there will be any rekindling there. And perhaps Chrishell will post more receipts. She does say she has them. Don't poke the bear. So, I feel like Keo should just kind of back it up now.
Or Keo should poke, because I want to see the receipts.